Hi, it's Kip K back with another weekend project from the pages of Make Magazine. Most digital cameras, from inexpensive to the higher priced models, usually have a timer function where you can set it anywhere from 10 to 20 seconds and then you can run and get in the picture to take a self-portrait. Well, what if you're in a situation where there's a gap between you and the camera, or it's a fairly long distance and there's no way you could make it in time to get in the picture? Well, there's a great project that'll take care of that. It's called the 2-mile camera remote. And that's what we're gonna build on today's weekend project.
Make Volume 15 is where you'll find the 2-mile remote project by Tom Rogers. You'll need a simple digital camera, a pair of inexpensive FRS radios, and an assortment of parts. You can find the complete part list by clicking the link in the description of this video that takes you to the PDF for the project. The first step is to take apart your digital camera. Every camera will be different, so locate all of the screws and remove the housing completely. And please pay attention to the capacitor for the flash, because even if the batteries have been out for a while, this cap may still be charged, and it can deliver a wallop of a shock if you're not careful. Once you've completely removed the board, it's time to locate a couple of connections. By matching the camera case to the board, we want to locate the power button and then also the shutter button for the camera, because we're going to be accessing those contacts. It's time to solder, and two small wires will be soldered to the power button, and then also another one will be soldered to the connection for the shutter release. Oh, and we need one more wire soldered, and that will go to ground. While the project calls for using hot glue to cover the connections, I kind of favor liquid electrical tape, so I'll put on a generous amount to protect those connections. We won't be needing the two buttons in the case, one for power and one for the shutter release, so you can remove those little plastic buttons and discard them. Then put the camera back together, feeding those three wires we soldered through the shutter release hole. Now when your ground makes contact with the wire that we soldered to the power button, the camera powers up, and the same will happen with the shutter release. Well, we need something to mount the switches and the jack in, and the project calls for making a small metal box, so I made a little template, traced it out, cut it, bent it, drilled some holes, and mounted the power and shutter release switch and the stereo jack, and then used some Velcro to attach it to the camera. Now it's time for more soldering. We'll add two momentary switches and then also an 1/8-inch stereo panel mount audio jack. And now it's time to pop open one of our two-way radios, so the same process, remove all the screws and open up the case. In this case, the antenna needed to come out before the actual circuit board could be removed, and it'll reveal just two wires going to the speaker. Now we need to locate and tie into three different connections on the radio. One is the call button, the signal line for the speaker, and then also another ground location. And again, we'll solder three more small wires to each of those connections, and then also to another 1/8-inch stereo panel mount audio jack. Close everything back up securely, and if there's room inside for that panel mount jack, install it. In my case, there wasn't, so I just hot glued it to the side of the radio. For some reason, the project called for a 6x4x2 project box, but this seemed kind of large, so I located a smaller box that fit better for this project. Now you'll need to assemble the time delay controller circuit, and there's a link along with this video where you can find the schematic, so go ahead and build that and get that ready to go in the box. Once it's complete, install it in the box with a 9-volt battery, and also add the serial adapter and then a serial cable which will be used to program the microcontroller. I won't go into great detail on how to do that for the sake of time, but all the details are in the PDF, so go ahead and program the microcontroller. Put everything in the box and close it up, and add two stereo plugs, and your timer control box is ready to go. Here's how it all works. Our timer delay controller box is plugged into our radio. The radio is turned on and tuned to a free channel. The controller is turned on, and then the other end of the controller cable is plugged into our camera box. And then the camera is turned on. Now by using the other radio and pressing the call button, that will start about an 8-second countdown before the camera shutter is released. And that's how to take a remote control picture up to 2 miles away with the 2-mile camera remote. We'll see you next time with another weekend project.